Hi, I'm Philipp Schwizer and I will highlight our new cinema option, a powerful extension to the XL2, allowing you to commission and maintain professional cinemas in compliance with the SMPTE standard. Let me first give a brief overview over the typical workflow of the cinema meter in the lifespan of a theater. The experienced cinema engineer first creates a namespace on the XL2 to save his calibration data. For example, let's use the name of the cinema. Placing the microphone at the preferred listening position, he tunes then the frequency response and sound pressure levels of each speaker in the cinema to best match the so-called X-curve. He records and saves the curves as reference tests, and they can be used in the future for verification of the speakers. With the support of the built-in assistant, a service technician can then periodically verify whether the speakers are still within the allowed tolerance bands. If the speakers are out of spec, at any time in the future, the cinema engineer can review the verifications together with the original reference curves and take the necessary actions to optimize the performance of the audio system in the theater. Let's now look at this procedure in practice. Start the cinema option from the main menu and create a new cinema. Here we choose the name of the cinema, specify the cinema size, and optionally adjust the measurement time for the screen channels as well as for the LFE. The namespace for saving the calibration data is now created. We choose a channel to calibrate. Tolerance limits are predefined according to the SMPTE standard. We place the measurement microphone at the first measurement location, activate pink noise, and press start. Adjust the frequency response and absolute level with your processor so that it fits in the tolerance bands. Wait for the measurement period to elapse and capture this reading to any of the 8 memory locations. Repeat the measurement for the same channel with the microphone placed at other locations. You may perform spatial averaging on any combination of the saved captures by calculating the mean response curve directly on the XL2. To create the reference curve for future verifications, we use any of the captures or measure again at the preferred listening position, so-called golden seat. From this reading, we now create the reference curve. After the reference curve is created, it is automatically loaded, allowing us to verify it with a measurement. And it fits.
Once the calibration process is completed and all reference curves are created, we can periodically verify the performance of the sound system against these reference curves. This process can be conducted by a service technician who is not necessarily an acoustics expert. The verification test is a simple and guided process with clear instructions. The aim is to periodically verify and document that the channels still behave as originally calibrated. Let's verify a channel. The assistant guides us step by step through the cinema and channel selection process and tells us the required activity. The verification measurements are then conducted and compared against the reference curves. The verification results can be stored in the capture memory, complemented by the date and time of the verification. In case certain channels fail the verification process, the technician can advise the cinema engineer to recalibrate.
The cinema engineer has access to all stored captures of his calibration work, the reference curve, as well as the stored verification measurements. Each of these measurements can be compared with another during the recalibration process. Such a workflow ensures that you are always able to get the best sound quality from a cinema. NTI is committed to helping you be the best.